An anticyclone is a region of high atmospheric pressure relative to the surrounding air, generally thousands of kilometers in diameter and also known as a high or high pressure system. Anticyclones appear on weather charts as a series of concentric widely spaced isobars of 1000 MBS and above. The roughly circular closed isobar at its central region indicates the area of high pressure. The center of an anticyclone has a characteristic pattern of air circulation, with subsiding air and horizontal divergence of the air near the surface. Winds, generally light, circulate around the high pressure center in a clockwise direction in the northern hemisphere and anti-clockwise in the southern hemisphere. The subsiding air compresses as it descends, causing adiabatic warming. The eventually warmer and drier air suppresses cloud formation, and thus anticyclones are usually associated with fine weather in the summer and dry, cold, and sometimes foggy weather in the winter. Anticyclones are typically relatively slow-moving features. The first stage in preparing a synoptic chart is to chart the position of each meteorological station. These are marked by a small circle. The weather report for each station is then plotted in and around the circle. Elements like temperature and pressure are entered as plane figures. Others like occurrence of rain, snow, cloud, and fog are plotted as internationally agreed symbols. When plotting of the meteorological observations is completed, the forecaster then proceeds with the synopsis and analysis of the chart. The first step is to draw on the isobars lines, along which the pressure is the same. They are of the same nature as height contours on a geographical map. Usually, they are drawn at intervals of 2 or 4 millibars. By definition, isobars can never cross each other. The completed isobars usually reveal a few standard patterns. A set of curved isobars surrounding an area of low pressure reveals a depression, with the wind in the northern hemisphere blowing anti-clockwise around its center. A set of curved isobars surrounding a high pressure reveals an anticyclone, with the winds in the northern hemisphere blowing clockwise around its center. In the northern hemisphere, winds blow in a clockwise direction around high pressure. The highest pressure occurs at the center and is known as the high pressure center. Anticyclones can bring warm and sunny weather in summer but cold and foggy weather in winter. A depression, also known as a low, can be recognized on a weather chart by an area of closely spaced isobars open in a roughly circular shape where pressure is lower than surrounding areas. They are often accompanied by fronts. In the northern hemisphere, wind blows around the depression in an anti-clockwise direction. The lowest pressure occurs at the middle of a depression. This is known as the low pressure center. Depressions are often associated with strong winds and heavy rain and are nearly always accompanied by fronts. Troughs are elongated extensions of areas of low pressure. They bring similar weather to that associated with depressions. Ridges are elongated extensions of areas of high pressure. They bring similar weather to that associated with anticyclones. A col can be identified as an area of slack pressure between two anticyclones and two depressions. The following diagram summarizes the appearances on a weather chart of the main types of pressure systems. And shown here is a synopsis chart. After understanding the terms that were discussed earlier, we will be able to read this synopsis chart smoothly.